Good morning. Welcome to worship at Grace United Church in Sarnia. My name is Pat Morrison and I'm a minister here at Grace. Grace is an affirming ministry of the United Church of Canada, and the people of Grace are disciples of Jesus Christ who strive to be an inclusive intergenerational community partner. I'd like to begin by acknowledging that the land on which I stand is the traditional territory of the Chippewa, Odawa, Potawatomi, and Delaware nations. A couple quick announcements before we begin. Members and adherents of Grace are reminded to stay tuned at 11 o'clock this morning for the congregational meeting. Information regarding the meeting was sent out by email by Lori earlier this week. Feel free to sign in early to afford time for troubleshooting if necessary. Artwork for this morning's service was provided by Hannah McClure. It's a piece she created using dry erase markers on her kitchen window. So it was a challenge for her mother, Diana, to snap a photo. The only thing you really can't make out is text around the perimeter of the picture that says, Jesus loves me. So thank you to Hannah for sharing your gift and to Diana for forwarding it. I invite you now to consider the place where you are to be a sacred place or a sanctuary, if you will. Take a moment to collect yourself, to recall the week that was, and the week that is to come, and to carry both of these with you into our time of worship. Take a moment to center yourself as Glenn offers up the first gift of worship on our behalf. Please join me in the prayer of approach as printed. God of eternal peace, grant us an ease to breathe deeply of this moment, beneath the din and fury of terrifying movements and harsh news and urgent crises. Make us attentive still to good news, to small occasions, and the grace of what is possible for us to be, to do, to give, to receive. Grant that sense of peace that adds perspective toward understanding. Grant that gift of gratitude that adds persistence to courage. Grant the quietness of spirit that adds irrepressibility to hope. Grant an openness of mind that adds surprise to joy, that with gladness of heart we may link arm and aim with the one who saw signs of your kingdom in salt and yeast, in pearls and seeds, travelers and tax collectors, sowers and harlots, foreigners and fishermen. Open our eyes to these signs and open our ears to your summons as we meet to worship you. Amen. Even in the midst of a shaken world, Jesus appears to his disciples who are locked in an upper room, and he speaks these words, "Peace be with you." Even in the midst of a shaken world, Jesus' words chime across the centuries and ring true even in this moment. Peace is with you. There's this thing available to us called peace. It's a gift. And we receive it as such, and therefore we share it. I invite you to take a moment to recall those who usually sit around you in the pew in front and behind, and even those with whom you live and work. And again, imagine approaching them with an extended hand and looking them in the eye and offering them the peace of Christ. The peace of Christ be with you all. In this time of church closure, the ministry of Grace United Church continues. The hungry are fed, the thirsty receive drink, the sick and the lonely are visited, our children are gathered, and our elders are held. Along with the financial offerings received, we take a moment to offer thanks to God for those who continue in service, holding on to this moment of shared peace. I invite you to take a moment again to think on that for which you are thankful. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Peace be with you. Lift up our hearts. Let us give God thanks and praise. Good morning, I'm happy to be here with you. I want to talk a bit about that phrase, peace be with you. We hear it every Sunday morning, and we say it to one another every Sunday morning. And we hear it from the scriptures that Jesus offers peace to others. And this morning, the scripture is about Jesus' friends being caught, stuck inside, locked away, unsure what's going on. They're very wound up, they're very tight, they're very unsure, and they're fearful. And Jesus appears to them and says, friends, peace be with you. Kind of like what we got going on right now with ourselves. We're all stuck at home, we're all wound up tight. We don't know what's going on. We don't know when things will change. We don't know, we just don't know. But yet we as brothers and sisters in Christ, you know, our job and our faith is to offer that peace to one another, to remind them that God is there and that peace can be found. And I think that's a beautiful thing, and I think that's a wonderful thing that we can do with one another, to remind ourselves that we are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Our gospel reading this morning comes from the book of John. In the passage, John tells the post-resurrection story of Jesus appearing to his disciples in the upper room. John fashions the story so as to make a subtle reference to the second creation story of Genesis, where, quote, God formed man out of dirt from the ground and blew into his nostrils the breath of life. The man came alive, a living soul. John, clever as always, but not for the sake of being clever, but rather trying once again to help his community come alive to the resurrection moment, to help them understand the resurrection life available to them, speaks the language of creation, of new creation, of re-creation. Let's listen now as Joanna offers that story.
A reading from John chapter 20, verses 19 to 31. Listen for the urging of God. Later on that day, the disciples had gathered together, but fearful of the Jews, had locked all the doors in the house. Jesus entered, stood among them, and said, peace to you. Then he showed them his hands and side. The disciples, seeing the master with their own eyes, were exuberant. Jesus repeated his greeting, peace to you, just as the Father sent me, I send you. Then he took a deep breath and breathed into them, receive the Holy Spirit. He said, if you forgive someone's sins, they're gone for good. If you don't forgive sins, what are you to do with them? But Thomas, sometimes called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples told him, we saw the Master. But he said, unless I see the nail holes in his hands, put my finger in the nail holes, and stick my hand in the side, I won't believe it. 8 days later, his disciples were again in the room. This time Thomas was with them. Jesus came through the locked door, stood among them, and said, peace to you. Then he focused his attention on Thomas. Take your finger and examine my hands. Take your hand and stick it in my side. Don't be unbelieving. Believe. Thomas said, my master, my God. Jesus said, so you believe because you've seen with your own eyes. Even better blessings are in store for those who believe without seeing. Jesus provided far more God-revealing signs than what are written down in this book. These are written down so you will believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and in the act of believing, have real and eternal life in the way he personally revealed it.
Please pray with me. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, our Rock and our Redeemer. Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Taking a stand in Baton Rouge. A man killed. Alton was his name. Killed for what? Was it lawful? Justified? The jury is still out. The people divided. Angry, both sides, all sides. Black Lives Matter. The state charged with keeping the peace. A crowd gathers, unnoticed by the world, until the cameras roll in, to catch this. A pregnant moment created by one. A language understood by one, offered to the world, a resurrection moment captured in real time. In the midst of the noise, the confusion, the riots, Molotov cocktails, looting, this, she stands. She stands peaceful. No words. No fear. She's beautiful, right where she stands, beautiful for her stance. Without a word speaking, see here my hands, shackles of the state. No, recast in this moment as what? Something above the law, a new law. Liberation. Yes, liberation. She stands. There she stands. Peaceful. Despite it all, there she stands. An offering of peace. Golgotha, the place of the skull, the place of public execution. A man killed. Killed for what? Treason? Was it lawful? Justified? The disciples all in one room, surrounded by noise, Passover. Soldiers linger, the presence of Rome, charged with keeping the peace, keeping order. Yes, order. How long will might bring about order? How long will might bring about peace? And what kind of peace at that? There he stands. He stands among them. Peace. One word, peace. Spoken twice, peace. Peace be with you. See here my hands, scars of the state. No, recast in this moment, liberation from the state, something above the law, a new law. But more, here he stands, peaceful despite death. There he stands, he breathes liberation from death, from the fear of death, offering peace, a new peace. Alberta Health Services Edmonton Distribution Center, where personal protective equipment is stored and deployed. Many have already been killed across the country. Many more deaths to come among the sick and the healthcare worker too. Why? Is it necessary? The stockpiling of PPE, is it justified? Is it legal? The jury is out, at least south of the border. Then the pregnant moment created by one. The announcement, $41 million in PPE to be shared. The press gathers, charged with informing the people. Kenny, charged with keeping order, protecting Albertans, extends his hand. See here the hands of frontline workers, all frontline workers. See their hands, the instruments of life alongside the most vulnerable to death. See here the hand of the state opened to offer the tools of the state. No, the hand of the state opened to offer hope, the kernel of peace. It's not law, it's above the law, an offering of peace. Peace not found next to a stockpile, but in the letting go, the opening of the hand, the offering of a hand. A decision, resolute, a conviction above the law. See here the hands of Canadians, noisemakers on their front porch, the response of those who witness all that is above the law, the ones who join their voices with the disciples and say, "We saw the Master and we applaud." In the midst of the noise, confusion, death, this, they stand. There they stand in the face of horror, in the face of beauty, confessing in the display of courage and care, we saw the Master at work. See here, hands sanitized dozens of times today, beating the song of the disciples on common kitchen tools. No, tools recast as instruments that feed beyond the kitchen table. The words of Jesus, "Take your finger and examine my hands." Examine these hands and hear Jesus' words. Don't be unbelieving. Believe peace. Peace be with you. Amen. God calls us to draw close and examine the wounded hands and feet of the risen one, that we might know the depth of his love for us. We approach God in confidence as we pray for all people according to their needs.
Tripping.
faces touched by the light of new day, and hearts warmed by the empty tomb, we come before you to pray for the needs of our world. In light of Easter resurrection, we raise up those who are struggling with illness, those who despair over their lives, or despair over the brokenness of relationship. May the peace of Christ be shared. May the peace of Christ be known. May the peace of Christ be theirs. Easter resurrection, we offer those places in our world where violence plays out, where poverty seems crushing, where sickness is unrelenting, darkening the everyday. May the peace of Christ be shared. May the peace of Christ be known. May the peace of Christ be theirs. Easter resurrection, we recall the news headlines of the week. We hold in our hearts the pain of those suffering violence, bereavement, conflict. May the peace of Christ be shared. May the peace of Christ be known. May the peace of Christ be theirs. Resurrection, we bring ourselves, our private struggles, the heart's yearnings, dreams crushed, relationships broken, the heavy moments. May the peace of Christ be shared. May the peace of Christ be known. May the peace of Christ be ours. Also offer to your care those among us whom we love, those with whom we long to share and embrace in words of love those with whom we wish the peace of Christ. And so we lift up Johnny, Helen, Marilyn, Carrie, Jesse, Marie, Doug, Donna, Rick, Margaret, Anne, Tony, Kristen and family, the White family, Dorothy, Zeta, Curtis and Tracy, Jesse, and Shane. And we unite our voices with your church around the globe and across the centuries in the prayer your Son taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Go into the world to fulfill your high calling as ambassadors of peace, a peace that is beyond understanding, a peace that is above the law, and a peace that is plentiful to share. Go in peace. Amen.